So hi there, welcome to a new video. We're just doing some drawing today. I'm messing around with ink and wash for an upcoming project. I just wanted to try something a bit different. So quick video this week. I don't want to sort of waffle, so if I do, then this video will become edited, and I'm already starting. So let's keep on target now. I want to introduce you to someone. This is Danny Wallace. Now, Danny Wallace, he's like a British filmmaker, comedian. He's a writer. He's been on TV. He does a lot of radio work. I believe he's written columns for The Guardian. He's kind of a bit of a Renaissance man. One of the things he's also done is he's written books. And he wrote a book back in 2005 called Yes Man. And in that book, he spent 6 months just saying yes to any offer. So, new credit card, yeah. Join a Flat Earth Society, yeah. Trim your neighbour's hedge, yeah. All this stuff. And it resulted in a sort of a mixed bag of things. But generally, the experience was mostly positive. And I think that's a great thing. Yes is a great word to say. It's very affirming. I mean, you can't say yes without being affirmative, right? Yes, I'm going to help you. Yes, I'm going to do this thing. Yes, I'm going to seize the day. And that's really cool. And as creators, it's a superpower we have. We can say yes, and we can help a writer get their vision onto a page, you know, specifically with comics and illustrations, stuff like this. And it's a superpower that we have, and with every superpower, with great power comes great responsibility. So today I just want to remind artists, yourself, about the awesome power of saying no to some things. So I'll tell you where this is coming from. The start of the year, about February, I had a meeting with a client. I've done a lot of projects with in the past. He's a good client, a good friend, and whenever this client comes through with like something that they want me to work on, I'm always very excited to say yes, let's make that happen. Mainly because the projects are usually super fun and they are educational, and there's lots of positives to be had for that. This time around, the project was a big book with lots of illustrations on there. The initial pitch was, we have two illustrators working on this. One illustrator is doing all sort of backgrounds and door page spreads. We just need you doing a little illustration on the left-hand page. So, okay, 20 pages in effect, because it's 40 pages, but if it's door page spreads, that means there's only 20 illustrations. Brilliant. So I sort of signed up on the proviso. I'd already got some work in progress for Comics from the Kitchen and a bunch of other things. So we sort of deferred the start on that until April. So April comes along and I meet all my sort of deadlines for Comics from the Kitchen, and I'll make a start on this new project. And I get the brief from the client, and the client has a way of writing the brief, which essentially is just a massive text file describing the characters and then in each illustration what they're doing on that page. It means that the client doesn't give me his manuscript. I work to his art direction, and then, you know, it sort of works. So I started drawing, making the drawings, and it's 20 drawings. It's a lot of work, you know. It's a lot of sort of working late night, and it's kind of a grind, but you work through it. Got the work in just before the deadline in August, so the deadline's only just gone. And then my client gets back to me, he's like, we've got some problems. I was like, okay, what's the problem? When we start laying your image on top of the other illustrator's work, nothing fits properly. And here's the problem. I didn't have access to the other illustrator's work. All I had was the brief, which said, draw these characters doing X, Y, and Z. So I drew those characters doing X, Y, and Z. I had a meeting with the client. I said, there's no way we can get this to your deadline in like 3 days. Not a chance. The other illustrator who's doing all the background spreads has still got 3 images to submit. I've submitted all mine. We're still waiting on them to submit theirs. So we can't fix anything until we've got them all. And then we've only got a couple of days to fix them. My client says, well, it's not a problem. This is really just to get a proof of concept. The illustrations might look janky and they don't work, but we can say this proves the concept. Our final print deadline is March next year. So I've got to redraw the book, my illustrations for the book. Now we've got all the background illustrations, this should be a lot easier. However, think about it now. By the time this is finished, I'll have spent a year on this project. A year. And as a result of that, Windbreaker has basically been chucked on the back burner for a big chunk of this year. I'd started Windbreaker in February and I mothballed it from April to August to get this project out of the way. Now there's a chance I'm going to have to mothball Windbreaker again to get this thing to its March deadline. So my philosophy going forwards is that I will instead, if I've got a project on the go, if I'm doing my own project, I'm not mothballing projects anymore for other people. I'm sorry, I'm going to start saying no to these projects. And it seems bad, but ultimately, I've got to do what's right for my books as well, you know? Yes, never underestimate the power of saying no. Sometimes you need to focus on your project. And sometimes your project is more important. So, like, comment, share, subscribe. Windbreaker is going really well at the moment. We are at just under 50% inked. We've been back on it now for about 2 weeks. So this is going really well. We should probably get the inking finished by first week in October. And then there's colouring and lettering. And, I'm hoping to have the book finished by the end of the year, and sort of means 2024 we'll be launching a Kickstarter for it. So hang around, find out what's going on. Join us next time, dear viewer. We'll do some more drawing videos, and I'll see you in the next one. All right, take care. All right, bye now.